Hello, fellow truth seekers. I hope that you're all doing well and staying safe. So, my name is Christiana. For those who have not been here before, welcome. For those who have, welcome back. So, I'm going to be talking about the energies that are going to be affecting us in May 2020. And we'll be talking about the astrological aspects at first, in a weird kind of way. And then we will get the cards involved. So, yeah, it's going to be an interesting month, guys. And I just realized I usually do a first go through because it ends up being really, really long the first time around. And then I do a second one. So, after I've done it, I have a song for us, and we'll get to it in just a few minutes, but I realized it really ties into the astrology. I don't know why it hit me that it would, and then I looked and I was like, yeah, okay, there it is. All right, so now that I have enticed you, let's get into it. So the big thing that's happening this month are a bunch of retrogrades, and all is tying in together. So, and it's all happening from every day something happens involving those planets, the 11th, the 12th, the 13th, and the 14th. Then, and this is first Saturn goes retrograde, then Venus, and then Jupiter. Saturn and Jupiter are coming in. You might remember that, I think it was back in March, possibly, that they came close to a conjunction. But in December, they are conjuncting. December 21st, the solstice. So that is super interesting to me. Okay, let's move on. So, May 11th is the first date that we have on the agenda. The same day that Saturn goes retrograde in Aquarius, we have Mercury entering Gemini. So, we all can finally think straight. Right? Clear thinking, logical thinking, thoughts that we can have faith in, right? Because in Pisces, not that there wasn't legitimacy to them, but it was kind of muddied and a little up in the air, right? So Saturn turns retrograde in Aquarius, 1 degree of Aquarius, which is the self, the magician. And I feel like we've realized, we've been talking about it a lot, that what work we do on ourselves affects the entire collective, right? Saturn is all about karma, the limits, the regulations, the rules. And if you'll remember when it moved into Aquarius, at 0 degrees, I was all excited about it because Aquarius is about the future and the number 0 is all about possibility. So we were getting to do a reset. Well, now it's going retrograde. It's going to go back over that 0 degree marker and we're going to get another chance to do some manifesting, think about the future we want, and then it's going to go back into Capricorn. We're going to go back over all the stuff that, yay. But then it will come back over that 0 degree point once again, 3 times. 3 is a magical number. 3 times a charm, right? So I really dig this. I think it's going to be really good. The next day, on the 12th, Mercury trines Saturn. So we just had both of them doing something the day before. The next day, they trine each other, which is a harmonious aspect. And I'm kind of seeing this as, being clever to get past the rules, right? Or sweet talking. your way past the rules. Yeah, there's this way that we're getting to bypass the rules that day, I feel. Especially with Saturn in retrograde. It's like, it's backstepping, right? It's really a good thing, I think. The next day, the 13th, Mars moves into Pisces, which is watering Mars down a bit, right? It's not quite as active. And this might have an effect on us physically, right? So we'll want to try to do our best to stay active, right? Keep those juices flowing. And Venus moves into Gemini at 21 degrees, which is the world. And I'm seeing this as that one love, right? That feeling of togetherness that we've started coming into, and just that we're all connected. And of course, this is going to bring up stuff from the past, right? And this brings me to the song, okay? Because in the last time that Venus went retrograde in Gemini was 8 years ago, or actually in 2012. So this song has been on my mind. It came up in somebody's reading. It came into my mind. And it's been in my head ever since. And I was just like, I'm supposed to use this for May. And it's Summertime Sadness by Lana Del Rey. And I was curious. I don't know what made me do it. But I was like, when was that released? So I looked it up and it was released as a digital download in Germany on June 22nd, 2012. So June 22nd is the day after, 8 years on the 8 years to the day, almost. June 21st of this year, we have a solar eclipse in Gemini. So I find that very interesting, because 2012, what was going on back then for you? Because I feel like it's relevant to now. So explore that a little bit. But I wanted to read the first two stanzas of that, and now that it really does tie in, I'm all psyched. Because it's kind of, you know, for this last month, I've really been talking about really, you know, and I think we've been feeling that energy, right? Just feeling alive no matter what, right? And even, you know, I brought up that song, Summertime Sadness, because it's like, even sometimes when you're feeling sad, you know, it's depending on how you handle it, you know, it can really, you know, there's a beauty to it. There's a beauty to all of our emotions. So just get into whatever you're feeling and just see the beauty in it, right? And I think that actually helps us come out of it, helps us to accept it, etc. Okay, at any rate, I'm gonna read the lyrics now. I got my red dress on tonight, dancing in the dark in the pale moonlight. Done my hair up real big, beauty queen style. High heels off, I'm feeling alive. Oh my God, I feel it in the air. Telephone wires above are sizzling like a snare. Honey, I'm on fire, I feel it everywhere. Nothing scares me anymore. And for those, you know, some of y'all might not know, but a snare is a drum, of course, and has those wires inside are held real tight. And so when you, you know, hit that snare, it's like, and so, and I feel like, you know, when I was reading that the first time through, I really thought about my people who are going through awakenings. And, you know, it can be really intense, right? So there's a certain amount of feeling alive, and there's a certain amount of just feeling drained sometimes, right? So just you know, I just feel like this song really speaks to that embracing of whatever we're dealing with at any given time. And when we do have those moments where we're feeling, you know, just happy and alive, to really embrace it, like really grab onto it, right? So yeah, keep that in mind. So yeah, and I feel like this is going to then we have on the 14th, okay, Jupiter turning retrograde at 27 degrees of Capricorn. And we have, you know, if the 27 breaks down to a 9, which is the Hermit, and May is the number 5, the Hierophant, it's about change. We're going to, you know, and this is, yeah, and we are looking at the self. We are looking at our origins, right? We're going back in time. We're really looking over our spirituality, our purpose, right? The karma, the spirituality, the love, right? These are big aspects of ourselves that are all, you know, this is all happening within days of each other. And I think we're gonna have some realizations. And yes, we are doing some of that self-work, but you know, we can't rush laying the foundation, right? We can't rush this change. We have to do it right. We have to get it right. So be patient, right? This, the 14, it's the, this happens on the 14th, and it happens at 27 degrees 14 minutes of Capricorn. And Jupiter rules Sagittarius. 14 is the temperance sign. So, you know, this is, there's some alchemy happening, yes. We're needing to have patience with the process. And there's also a sense of, you know, waiting for the inspiration. You know, not rushing things. Because I know we're ready. I know we're ready. But just really hang on to those special moments. Be patient in the meantime. Do the shit that needs to be done. And yeah. There's a sense of looking at our life and really looking at the parts of ourselves that maybe, you know, the shadow side has been coming a lot up for a lot of people, and you know what I think it's meaning for the most part, that, you know, those parts of ourselves that we overcame, that is something that we can share with others, right? We might, you know, if we were an alcoholic or a drug addict or you know, whatever it may be, whatever, you know, darkness that you were in, if you came in, the deeper that it was, the more you should revel in the fact that you were able to overcome that you were able to come out of that, and you have a special gift to share, right? So, yeah, I think that's a part of it. So, I think that's all that I need to say. I think. Let's see what the cards have to say. Hello, my beautiful Cancerians. I hope you are all doing well and staying safe. So my name is Christiana. I will be performing this reading for you today regarding the energies that will be affecting you during the month of May 2020. And it does look to be another intense month. Oh, a kitty wants to say hello. Hello, Simone. Come on. All right. So, this is for Sun, Moon, Rising, and Jupiter, as my readings tend to be of a more spiritual nature. Remember that we all have masculine and feminine energies. You can be either side of this story. All right, if we don't, this is going to be what chakra needs the most attention this month. Since these energies are pretty intense still, make sure you're grounding, right? Regardless of whatever comes up. All right, there we go. Dreams. Oh my gosh, and clarity. This third eye chakra has been huge, huge this month. Almost every reading has had it, at least at the bottom of the deck, if not both cards. So you got two here. We've got inner child and dreams. So your heart chakra and your third eye chakra are needing attention. And that inner child, I feel like, you know, of course there could be some healing that's needed there, right? Some issues that need looking to be looked at. But I think more than anything, getting in touch with it and, you know, just kind of having fun, right? What does the inner child need? Look at that. We've got Janis Joplin and Eve Klein, that blue flame love, right? That higher consciousness love. Your dreams have important messages for you. They could even be messages that will lead to the healing of your inner child. So make sure you're, you know, and leading to clarity, right? Underneath clarity is the nurturing card, and we see, you know, and I feel like this is your inner child here. And of course, by feeding ourselves, nurturing ourselves, we're better able to take care of our children, others. But these dreams, pay very close attention to your dreams. You might even want to write them down upon waking. All right. So this next card is going to be an artist that has a message for you. Gustav Klimt, nice. Okay, and we have Grayson Perry at the bottom of the deck. And I always get a very inner child kind of feeling from this as well. And of course, we will take a look at all of the underlying energies at the end of the reading and see what story they have to tell. Gustav Klimt. Once again, the blue, also the yellow, which is the solar plexus, that masculine energy. Yeah, it even says here, like gold, eroticism fluctuates with the times. Every portrait is a self-portrait. If no group will have you, start your own. But you're wearing that blue, right? And I look at this eye up here, right? That third eye. Transformation is happening. And of course, he's known for the kiss, right? And I didn't finish saying it, but this artist has something to teach you outside of this reading as well. So if you are so inclined, I encourage you to look up his work, right? Look up his life. What does it tell you? He was a bit of a, you know, it talks about the eroticism here, but he's known for the kiss. It's a really beautiful painting. But he was a bit of a scandalous guy. He was like the father of our country. He had a lot of kids. So, whatever that might mean to you. But more than anything, I'm just feeling the different colors, right? He did a lot of this blocking and different patterns. And of course, the blue, there's that kiss, right? All I can think about is the kiss. So look up that painting. Actually, I think it's in this book here. Let me see. JK. Yes, okay, awesome. So, how does that make you feel? Nice, yes. I think it's really beautiful. There's lots of different pieces to it, right? Lots of different feelings that we're getting, you know. And the ground, like I see these little tendrils going down, is like you grounding, right? Because with the new moon in Taurus, the guitarist got you kind of like off center, right? And here, you're very grounded. You're in the passion, you can feel it, but you're also very grounded. And that leads to this beautiful, I mean, like, I can only imagine what this looks like in person. All these little dots I can just imagine are like little gold flecks, right? And it's just like the whole atmosphere is amber, right? That golden color. Wow. Beautiful. All right. Let's see here. I want to start with the Wild Unknown archetype. Cancer, please. For Cancer, for May 2020. For Cancer, please. May 2020. Cancer. What messages do we have for Cancer? Ooh. Okay. Let's see what we've got here. I feel like we need one more. Ooh, goodness gracious, y'all. Okay. I feel like this is right here. Wow. Let's see if anything else wants to come out. If it hasn't come out by the third shuffle, I'm just going to stick with these three. Okay. Hey, one more. No. All right. Oh, with the queen at the bottom, we see a snake again in that gold color with surrounded by the red, which is the base chakra, grounded, beautiful, and blossoming. Push these up here. All right, I had that feeling that was it, but so, gnosis here, that's this innermost knowing, right? That inner knowing that this is your person, you know, the guitarist. And there's this psychic connection, right? With the bridge in reverse, I feel like there's this psychic connection between you, right? This third eye chakra. And this knowing, this feeling, you're feeling each other, right? We see the same rainbow colors. And this is awakening the lover in you and in them as well, right? With the bridge, this is very on both ends. And the lover is alive with feeling and really gets into all the sensuality, all the little pleasures, the small pleasures, right? All of a sudden, the lover sees them anew. Very alive feeling. And we see this golden kind of, I don't know what it is. It's like a pearl almost, but it's gold. But we see it here and here in this flower. All right. Okay, so let's get some more. We are going to start with, yes, okay. We're going to start, I'm going to get the main, a card for each week of the month. And the first week will be the 1st through the 9th, I do believe, from the Literary Witches Oracle. For Cancer, please. Okay, and they're ready to go. First week, Sandra Cisneros. Second week, Octavia Butler. And this is the body. And, you know, like I said, it's very sensual in nature. The future with Octavia Butler. Week 3, bees. And this often has a lot of different meanings for me. It's very similar to the 3 of Pentacles, but very sweet. Week 4, Virginia Woolf, the vision. Nice, okay. And at the bottom of the deck, we have, and I'm sure that I will be pronouncing this wrong, but Faru Farrokhzad, rebellion, breaking out of your shell. All right, so, and we will get clarification for each week, but just to go over what I'm seeing here, there is a lot of planning for the future, I feel. In this first one, there is, you know, we have the body here, Sandra Cisneros, and, you know, I'm really drawn to the fact, you know, and I'm not necessarily, I almost ignore it sometimes. But, you know, this is obviously the feminine here, but then it takes the shape of the sun. So this is combining, right, those masculine and feminine energies. And I feel, you know, that you're feeling into your body as far as that innermost knowing, right? It's like we can tell what the truth is by how our body reacts, right? It's like somebody tells you something that should upset you, but you're not upset, right? Why? Later on, you find out that it wasn't correct. You were given false information and you're like, oh, that's why I did, you know, I didn't feel anything. Or somebody tells you someone was in a car accident and you know you should be worried, and maybe you are, you know, you're like, oh, I need to find out, you know, of course. But there's a sense of calmness, right? And later you find out everything is fine. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? So, and then, of course, the opposite can be true. I feel like, you know, that's a big part of this. And, of course, just those sensual pleasures are definitely coming into play here. Now, I feel like with these black gloves, I feel like it's like you feel like maybe some sensual pleasures of the body are somehow off limits, and that's just not the case. That's what I'm feeling there. Okay. So Octavia Butler in the second week. There's obviously some thinking about the future, possibly some worrying about the future, planning for the future, and I feel like you're trying to pin your masculine down about it, right? Or you want that. You want to pin him down. But that's just not the case. And there's, she wrote science fiction, Octavia Butler. So there's this, you know, this connection that you all have is coming into play here as well. And it might have you a little bit off kilter, right? Then we have the bees here in week three. And it's, there are three bees here. And, you know, this is just work. I really feel like you're doing some work. You're collaborating with others. There's this sweetness, this, you know, it's enjoyable work. Whatever you're doing here is really enjoyable. You're having fun. It's really a good energy. And then week four, the vision here. And you see her looking at the past, but the vine is growing into the future. So I feel like this is like that inner child energy. And you're having to kind of like look at the past to find your future kind of feeling. And I, you know, there is a lot of that because we do have all those planets going into retrograde right at the middle of the month. So there is a sense of reevaluating it, looking over the past, what have we built? And there is, you know, you want to get into the future, but getting into those waters, right? We see her in these waters, which is the subconscious. And really digging into your past is going to actually help you build this future. All right, we are going to Tarot in Wonderland to get our clarification. For Cancer, please. And I'm keeping my cat's my cat's nephew. That's funny. My nephew's cat. And when she gets scared of the other cats, she takes it out on me. So I've got a couple little scratches. She doesn't mean it. She's just scared. For Cancer, please. Looking for clarification. Why? Ooh, okay. We got one. That was a whole bunch wanted to come out, but just the one fell. Okay, we'll look at it in a second. We're going to get one more card. Why is Sandra Cisneros here in week one? Well, okay, let's try again. Why is Sandra Cisneros here in week one? Whoa, why did a bunch want to come out? Good God. Okay, fine. Because the first time a bunch wanted to come out, so fine, we'll do it. Ooh, wow. Let's see what this is. The King of Cups. But the Queen of Wands at the bottom. Let's see what else we got here. Four of Swords. Eight of Pentacles. Chariot, there you are, Ace of Swords, Ace of Pentacles. Oh my word, you guys. I'm totally seeing some, like I said, you're not feeling like you want to. I feel like it's pleasure yourself, okay? I'm just gonna say it. Let me see if, okay, let me move this stuff up a little bit and try to reorganize this. I'll be right back, okay? All right. So, We have Gustav Klimt here with the eroticism fluctuates with the times. We've got the body here. And, you know, and I feel like you all are in separation. I feel like this is like a psychic connection. And there is this desire to connect, right? Like we see... the King of Cups here, right? Which is the masculine. We see the Four of Swords here, which is meditative, right? He's asleep here. And then we have the Eight of Pentacles, but it's purple. So I feel like there is this desire, and then we see it again here with the... and the Chariot is right in the midst of it all. And I'll explain what I'm seeing with the Chariot in just a minute. But we've got two mirrors here. And they're even facing off in separate directions, right? So it's like two sides of the mirror. The cake and the sword. And I feel, you know, this has got the purple all around it. So this is like the psychic connection, right? And making it and feeling it, right? You're actually feeling it. Like, I feel like, you know, y'all have this psychic connection, but you're really feeling it in the body. Okay, so. And that's what I feel like here as well. It's like... you know, there's this working on this connection, right? Getting it, learning how to really work with it and hone the skill, right? But also, I can't help but see, like, you know, there's like some limpness here and then holding that sword. I can't help but see it, guys. I can't not help but see it. And I feel like you all are working on this psychic connection and, you know, yeah, learning how to control it, how to work with it, and have your cake. I don't know, guys. That's what I'm seeing. All right. So, we can't have all of these here. I'm going to go with... I'm going to take these out. And as much as I like that sword being there, we're just going to leave these three so that we can see them. I feel like they're the most important. And we'll put these off to the side. And yeah, I mean, like, you're the Queen of Wands. You're all fired up here. All right, why is Octavia Butler here in week two? Why is Octavia Butler here in week two? Wow, they're spilling out all kinds of stuff. Okay, we've got Three of Swords at the bottom. Yeah, I feel like you're really, like, you're obsessing over the future of this in this week, right? You're trying to pin them down. Let's see here. We've got Queen of Swords, Four of Cups, Knight of Cups, Ten of Swords, Knight of Pentacles. Yeah, I'm just saying it's pretty straightforward, I feel. You are, you know, the Queen of Swords, like, you're holding up this... you know, this weapon here. I mean, you have it here. You have, you're ready to cut it off. You're ready. You're done with the playing around in the 4D or 5D or wherever, you know, in this psychic realm, right? The cups can be, the ethers, right? And you're done with it. You're ready to just end it. You want the real thing. You want reality with the Knight of Pentacles. Yeah. Keep these three here. What's going on in week three? The bees. What happens in week three? That one flew up. Okay. Two of Pentacles at the bottom. And we'll see how that plays out. There's that Seven of Pentacles, that Knight of Swords, with the Page of Pentacles. So, and the Seven of Pentacles. All right, so I'm seeing an offer being made. And this does seem to have to be like, you know, it could be that it's just real, you know, making it real. There's this kind of, you know, there's this desire to kind of run in and, I don't know. There's something kind of brash and too hasty about this Knight of Swords. And it is a unicorn, right? It's like, are you seeing this offer correctly? There's this need to evaluate it, right, with the Seven of Pentacles. There's a decision to be made with the Two of Pentacles. And of course, this is also my minor arcana version of the Magician. So there's this scent, you know, and we see these little teacups. Of course, you know, the the way that this deck is kind of makes everything a little more unknown in a way, right? It's like, and there's a reason for that, right? These are teacups. Are those really what you're manifesting? You know, it's that kind of thing. Like, we have the Ace of Wands here, which is a fiery new beginning. Passionate. Two of Swords. There is, you know, once again, this is a very difficult decision for you. There's this need to go within, right? The dreams. What are your dreams telling you? What's your third eye telling you? What's your body telling you? You know, you're wanting to walk away from anything that might not be real. You're tired of the, and you know, it's like it's hard for you to really hold on to this inner knowing, I feel. Yeah, it's like in this story, this pig turned, you know, whether it was a baby and then it turned into this pig. You know, she was trying to help it. She thought it was being mistreated. And, you know, it's like there's something that isn't, that's just a little bit off from this offer, I feel. Okay. So really get into your senses, right? We have three knights out on the board here because we had this Knight of Cups come out too. So the only one that we haven't seen is the Knight of Wands, which, and then maybe that's just what it is, right? You are looking back on the past still, who this person was in the past. The Knight of Wands, the player, right? The lover. And you're having a hard time trusting it, right? You've thrown out all these sandwiches here. and you're looking at this offer, like, is this, and there's seven sandwiches, seven of Pentacles. Will this sustain me? Will this offer sustain me? Since you've thrown those sandwiches out, I'd imagine yes. But listen to your spirit guides, right? That's this raven here. Listen to your spirit guides. What do they have to say about it? All right. Let's see what's going on here in week four with Virginia Woolf. Why is Virginia Woolf here in week four? Okay. That's interesting how they fell out. This one fell out first over here. Oh my goodness, with the raven. Listening to your spirit guides. Then what's this? Death. Oh, and it landed on this King of Cups, Page of Swords. With the Ace of Cups underneath it. Interesting. Temperance. All right, so it's interesting, you know, the Nine of Pentacles is the single girl card, right? So perhaps this death has to do with the end of you being single. Or perhaps this is ending this situationship, right? Kind of like saying no more of the vagueness. We do have the Page of Swords at the bottom, which, you know, he's holding a message here and he's wearing these hearts. And then we have this Ace of Cups. An offer of love, and then we have temperance. Just being patient can also be about the change of something, right? Mixing things together to get something new, which is what we're seeing here and here, right? It's the eat me, drink me. There's a certain magical alchemical process that's happening here. And the Five of Wands. Okay, I want to find out. I want to get one more card. What does this rebirth look like? Okay, wow, Four of Pentacles. Being conservative, right? That's that patience card. There's transformation, you know. We have the Queen of Wands here at the bottom again, with the Devil, that time. I feel like your biggest thing is coming to terms with the time factor. That, you know, this might take some time. There's some patience that's needed here. It's interesting. I'm looking at this smoke that's going over her head, right? It reminds me of this, and they're even like holding their hands, kind of similar. And she's sitting in the subconscious, these dark waters, which is transforming, right? Now, you know, there's this need for you to transform, to walk this path right now. Listen to your spirit guides, right? Be the lover. Find the lover in yourself. There's a little passage in the lover that is really, it's quite beautiful. Here it is. So it's the heart, the beloved, the devoted. And I'm just gonna read this because it's really quick. Pulsing through the heart of the lover is gratitude. The lover appreciates and experiences the world through the senses, reveling in beauty, song, art, music, scents, and sensuality. This energy awakens at the tip of our tongue when we taste the sweetness of honey, kiss a lover, or speak gentle words to a child. The lover lingers in foreplay, aroused not by the getting there, but by the slow merging of self and other. This energy is usually experienced for short periods of time, as in order to feel it, we must be fully present and awake, with no expectations or rules about what should be. Rather, the lover is in awe of what the world presents, reveling in the glorious details, grateful to savor every last drop of life's offerings. Then over here it says, it is common to seek the lover in another. The true gift is finding the lover in yourself. And I feel like that is what this is talking about, right? To stop looking for it outside. The transformation is within, right? So sit tight and transform. Everything will come about at the right time. There's healing for you to do. All right. Let's get a piece of art for you. We'll get closing guidance, and then we'll take a look at the underlying energies. All right. For Cancer, please. Let's go here. To the right. They always, look at this, another person, a guy on a horse. Okay. The Duke of Wellington. I guess, you know, I feel like in a way you're waiting for the prince to ride in, right? You're kind of in princess mode. And I feel like you need to become the knight. All right. We're getting closing guidance from angels and ancestors. Closing guidance for Cancer, please. Closing guidance for Cancer. All right, I feel like the balance between masculine and feminine needs to be worked on. Definitely. Closing guidance. There we go. Wow. Quite a few. Snake, shed old skin is at the bottom, right? That's this. All right, let's see what came out here. The Traveler, Medicine Guardian, be open to healing information, and Medicine Mother, honor your inner knowing. Once again, we're talking about the inner knowing. Traveler talks about traveling either literally or figuratively. Okay. I feel the need to read from Medicine Guardian. Then we'll see about Medicine Mother. Interesting, we have medicine. And we have all these, you know, the drink me and eat me card here. You all have been getting the healing. All right. Listen to what is coming up within you and what is being shared with you by trustworthy others in your life. Pay attention to healing information. Including this for you. Healing angels can help you heal emotionally, spiritually, and physically with their energy. But they can also direct you towards information that will help you return to wholeness. When this card appears, information is being revealed that can help heal an aspect of your current situation, whether that be your health, relationships, or even career. So be alert for this. The medicine guardian has a caduceus, a healing wand, which represents the capacity to heal with the power of will and desire, and a chalice, which represents returning to a state of wholeness. A state where your cup is no longer full, but overflowing with goodness. You are being exposed to information and insights that will have a dramatic healing effect upon your life. If you are working through something mentally or emotionally, know that there are spiritual energies supporting your healing. If you are working through something that is physically challenging, pay particular attention to information that's coming to you that feels inspired, insightful, and warm. It will be supportive of your wellness. Your angels are here to remind you that your natural state is one of wholeness, and you are on the road to revealing that wholeness once more. And of Medicine Mother, I don't feel the need to really read from that. It's, you know, what we've been talking about here, right? That inner knowing, you've got to trust it, right? And it talks about, there's something that you know you have to do. And to do it, to trust that inner voice. Okay, so the underlying energies, snake, shed old skin. And once again, you know, we've got snakes here. This right here is representative of the Ida, the Pingala, and the Sushumna. I've been saying that all wrong. And this is Kundalini awakening. You know, not necessarily what's going on with you with this, you know, but it's all possible. All right. Let's read from Snake. I'll go ahead and get the rest of these out, but I do want to read this because I think it's important. We have the Queen of Wands. We have Faru Faraxad. Rebellion. We have the Queen, another snake. We have Grayson Perry. Scratch at the surface until your fingers bleed. Meaning separates art from craft. Try something new, the old-fashioned way. And then we have clarity. And I do think you're reaching some sort of clarity this month. Right towards the end. All right, let's read this. Cast off the old. Reveal your true colors, talents, and gifts to the world. In many spiritual traditions, the snake offers powerful medicine. In tantric teachings, it symbolizes the kundalini, which is the powerful serpentine energy within that allows you to reach your highest spiritual potential. When the sacred ones saw a snake in nature or encountered one in a dream, they knew there was transformation in the air. The energy of renewal is washing over your life at this time. If for some reason you feel that your true self hasn't been recognized or you've been misread by others, know this energy is now leaving you. As you've been working through your old stories and all the self-limiting beliefs that you've accumulated along the way, you've been peeling away a shield of skin that has created limiting experiences. Your own personal commitment to growth has been recognized, and now the external world will begin to reflect all of the work that you've been doing within. If you feel someone you love has misunderstood you recently, they will be able to see beyond that if you're willing to recognize your own challenges. This is a time for renewal, abundance, and connection. Let yourself be reborn and celebrated. So, once again, I'm getting this, you know, this inner child work, right? And that, peeling away the skins, right? Scratch at the surface until your fingers bleed. Just, you know, keep pulling back the layers, right, is what I'm getting from that. And that will lead to that clarity. The queen, you know, I talked about that in the beginning. I just feel like, and interesting that we have this, you know, it's almost, it's the moon surrounded by this red, right? This grounding energy. And what a beautiful, you know, and then this is the sun around the, it's, you know, it's almost the opposite here. So that's really beautiful. And this is, you know, a balancing of the masculine and the feminine as well. Grayson Perry is, he is a man who dresses as a woman. And at least sometimes, right? He's a cross-dresser. So there is this, you know, that need to balance there, I really feel. Queen of Wands. Once again, we have another queen. They're really wanting you to own that, to love that. But, you know, there is a preponderance of feminine energy in this reading. And I really feel like, you know, they want you to really get into that masculine, because these are, you know, Sandra Cisneros. She wanted to, you know, she vowed she would always have her own home, always be able to take care of herself. And, you know, the Queen of Wands, both of them are, and, you know, this balance here, right? Which you can see this sun, that is that solar masculine energy. I feel like, you know, there's this need to stand on your own, to really, like, find that balance of the two within yourself, right? And rebellion here. You know, she has this wall up. Break out of this wall that you've built for yourself, right? You are Cancer, right? You've got that hard shell. You need to break out of it. I think that when, you know, shed that old skin, right? And if it's not, you know, I'm getting the sense that there's somebody out there that's like, you know, I've got my masculine energy on lockdown, you know? And if that, you know, does, if that is how you're feeling about it, then good. That definitely. Then maybe it's the opposite. Maybe you need to soften yourself a little bit, right? I just feel, get this feeling that there's this need to balance. Yeah. All right, guys. That is all I have for you today. I hope that it helped. I hope it resonated. If so, please remember to like, subscribe, comment, share. And until next time, much love.